ça va en entrer à Ovi, typically so. Is that we are in a country where people that should be celebrated continuously have not been celebrated as they should. And when you realize that the people that lived through your exploits, so many of them will also, you know, they are advancing in age, just like they are also advancing in the Olongeki, and if certain things are not documented properly, so that in cutting back bullet, you understand? But all of them are of not artificial. Do you understand? People will know that a great man, you know, once lived, once passed through Nigeria, once anchored our sport. So the way we want to go about this is to ask you to talk about your early life, your parents, family and all of those, your career. How did you get into football? How did you get into sports? How did you choose to be a manager? What are those principles that have guided your commitment, how you have approached the game? And what are those lessons that you think we can benefit from in how we reshape the situation of sports and football, especially in the conversation? Then secondly, at around the pictures, which very big, my colleague is taking some pictures. We would also like you to walk us through some of the, so those significant moments. I never knew you coached or managed the Water Corporation. So when you got to the issue of the career, the management part of it, you will please tell us about all the teams and some of the achievements and feats that you can remember that those teams, if only possible, the names of many of your players and some of those who are very memorable for you, those who are happy. You know, there are times when you say, look, I'm happy to have had this crop of talents under my management. So that is the way we want to go about it. And then, of course, round up with a question on your publications. We need to talk about that significantly, sir. Yes, sir.
Sorry, Tibero.
About Tibero.
Now, which forum is this?
See, this particular one, sir.
Yes.
Sir, this is, okay, let me put it this way. This idea of trying to interview illustrious Nigerians started with what we are doing with Government College Ibadan alumni. I am Olusha Yarowolo, school number 6006. He is Adekunle Aziz, school number 6007. He is a Swastin House and Powell House. We are 85 set of this year. Now, we realize that quite a number of our, apart from Olusha, we have quite a number of our other alumni. People don't hear about it. And we ask ourselves that, look, we are already 44 this year. You understand, sir? If we don't hear about other alumni, apart from Professor Olusha, how will generation after us hear
about us?
You understand?
Yeah.
So, we now decided to speak to one of our seniors, Mr. Abayomi Jones, about this project. Abayomi Jones is 1963, said, Abba, we are concerned that the current generation of students do not appreciate the weight of the uniform they are wearing, because heritage does not perish. Aṣọ tí wọ́n wọ̀ yìí làwọn Christopher Kọládé wọ̀, aṣọ yìí náà làwọn Professor Akinkugbe wọ̀. But quite a number of these people are making serious impact in their different areas, and not many people are even aware. And the only reason why so many people are aware of Professor Olusha Yinka is because apart from being a Nobel laureate, he has been engaged continually in social activism. So he's always in the news. And so people always get to know about him. But what of those other activists? So we now set out to
Make a point here.
Yes, sir.
I'm not an alumni.
I know. So
I was to be admitted in 1955. I attended the interview in 1954. But two things were against me. We were on that campus for a week.
My God.
Both theory, practice, and everything, sports.
This is what Professor Ayoboye
was telling us.
55 exactly, to be precise.
That's right.
We were with him on Tuesday.
So, but because I was a big boy, in those days, they would look at your age, they would look at your height, your size, before taking you in.
Wonderful.
And because I started primary school at 10, so you can imagine.
You were already 16 when you were trying to
okay.
enter GS1 or the form 1.
So, that was what was against me. That was why I was not admitted. I still admire the college. And I respect all the alumni, especially those who have made it in their different career.
So, in a sense, that was how. So, the chance meeting with you on the 13th of November was, and your receptiveness to us in terms of coming back to visit you was what led to the fact that Kunle and I decided that when we come, we would like, just like we have done for our alumni people, who we are about 15 now that we have been able to interview. In fact, as at yesterday, Chief Ajibola Obusola called me and said that, do you guys really know what you guys are doing? That you are going to put yourself under so much pressure because many of the...
Exactly.
That's what he was saying. That look, who is funding this? I said, Baba, don't worry now. We have chosen to do this. And at least, as God helps us, we will continually, as many as are receptive to allowing us to share with them, and they share with us and share with posterity, we will try and interview them as time goes on. So that is why we are here. It's not for any commercial whatever at all, not at all, sir. But sir, there are certain things.
For record purposes.
Yeah, exactly, sir. If you permit us to have the privilege, sir.
Well, I want to say again that I regard it as an honor to be considered as one of those who have to be highlighted somehow. As you said, I was born only yesterday. How long is it?
Are you yesterday?
How long is 80 years? I was born on March 5, 1938. Humble family, the Omadilola dynasty. He was Dagun of the community. It's a large family. As I said, it was and it is still a very humble family with a lot of honor. Because that is what we cherish most in our family, honor. And that is one of the things, that's one of the reasons why I tell people that I'm a fake Nigerian. You know, because an average Nigerian wants to amass wealth at all costs and from all sources. But I was brought up to put premium on good name and honor, service to the people. That has gotten me into a lot of problems with Nigerians professionally, even in the community where I was born. So, and principally, my family was an agricultural sort of family. ingredient in nature. So we'll go up, we'll go to the farm. Then an uncle of mine went out to learn how to beat the talking drum, the talking drum. And eventually became the Bale Onilu of Ndanike.
Wonderful.
In 1930. Before he died, I think in about 1968. So that brought almost the whole family.
At that time you would have been 30 years old. You were born in 1938.
Yes.
He died in 1968.
Yes, yes. So, and eventually became the Bale Onilu. So that changed the face of the family. And the compound became Bale Onilu compound. Whereas the original thing is Jagmomade Lola.
Do you have any memory of his talking beats that you can
that may be a topic for
another okay sir.
And I will explain.
Okay sir.
The first time I traveled out of this country, it was on talking drum. So it's not just a question of remembering what my uncle left.
Oh, as in you also became versatile in there.
Until now, I still beat the talking drum.
They will enjoy you in African church. Because I saw the almanac of African church.
Well, African church. In fact, I presented the talking drum to them. I've been the drummer in some church choirs. And as I said, my first journey out of Nigeria in 1972 was on talking drumming.
What event was that, sir?
I was a school teacher for 20 years before I went to the food coaching. And one of the places where I taught was the staff school, University of Ifeden, now Gotenburg University. And coincidentally, we had a member of staff who was a wife to late Olarutimi.
The gods are not obeyed.
So that lady was a drama artist, and he was on the Uriolukun, what do you call Uriolukun Theatre Arts, belonging to the University of Ife. We had our center in Ife,
And I think Prof. Wole Soyinka was also
was
yes
was.
With Prof. Akin, the late Prof. Akin Munisha.
Yes, yes. Then Akinba. Akinba was a musicologist. In that 1972, there was the Cultural Olympics in Germany. Cultural Olympics. So Akinba compiled a list of African poems and gave a general title, Gadages. So he got some people to render these poems with drumming background, different rhythms. You know, every deity in Nigeria has its own rhythm. Every deity has its own rhythm.
When we talk about Shango,
it has its own rhythm.
If we talk of it,
if you are Ogun, Obatala, Obatarisa. So we are playing the rhythms of this
in the background.
Yes, in the background. You are talking about Ifa. The rhythm of Ifa is Kererem, Kererem. You will see that that's a slow tempo.
Yes.
Because was an old, aged man. So the rhythm had to be slow. Unlike if you are drumming for Ogun, Ogun was a song man.
Then, So he compiled all of those. He had a poem. But was the poem
he focused on those of us who knew to the different rhythms.
No, sir. Are you saying to me that if somebody wants to be a talking drummer now,
yes,
there is a special technical training that he needs to go through? No, I'm saying that. Look, I appreciate the fact that every trade has some particular
approach.
So because for him to have selected those of you, he must have evaluated
now, before I got to him, there was a talking drummer from Oshobo, Lasisi Anyanshola, who was the husband of Susan Wenga.
Baba, you are opening books of history. You are opening chapters.
Lasisi Anyanshola was an illiterate, but very good in the art of talking drumming. So by the time I joined the Oriolokun in 1971, I was assisting him. He was the lead drummer. There were occasions, especially when he was not around.
So was it through Bale Onilu that you met last year?
No.
It was in your own.
We met at Oriolokun.
Oh.
I met him there.
Okay. What dragged you to Oriolokun?
Now, I was saying that Olarutimi's wife,
yes, was a dramatist.
Was a member of her staff.
Exactly.
Dramatist. Member of her staff at the staff school.
Oh.
And he saw my, because I was playing the drunken drum for the school.
Oh, no.
I was handling Yoruba cultural, you know.
Oh, I understand.
So he introduced me to her husband. She introduced me to her husband.
Now look, this is a talent.
And when I got in there, somehow Olarutimi, may so rest in peace, declared that I was a natural performer. So apart from talking drumming, I was Lamuwo in Lerem.
No, don't. I mean, that was as a stage play or as the movie.
Because you know
the one that NTA used to show to us that time, Lerem. Yeah, you know this
it
man.
It was recorded at that
this,
time.
This guy now. What's the name of this actor? Forgotten the but I can see clearly the Peter Patomilola.
You were there together.
In that one that NTA used to.
Yes. We were there together. I don't know if it was the one they recorded when I was there.
No. Because NTA, you know, it was had a lot of.
Yeah. We came to the.
I watched the room on NTA more than three or four times. Once we have this public holiday, very nice.
We had a lot of things. In Kurumi, written by Olarutimi. I was Balogun Ebikunle. In Kurumi.
I don't think I watched Kurumi.
Then of recent, there was...
You are still under 40 at that time. You are probably maybe 35, 36 at all these stages that we are talking about. Yes. Yes, 72 was when you traveled, and 72 you were 34.
So, some years ago, about 4 years ago or so, some people came to my house here. They got to know that I was an actor, a theater actor. And they said they wanted me on a book written by Warisu Yinka. Ake. It's a story of his youth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Many years I've
been
in my. Even though I've
not read it, but. I acted his maternal grandfather there.
Oh my God.
And then some people also came some years ago.
So in a sense, sir.
Yeah.
The issue with that is somewhat related to the Otis. Or which one?
Reverend Kuti.
I'm talking of
was Lansom the father Kuti. Of his mother.
Reverend Lansom
Kuti. Yes.
Was the father
of his mother. So his grandfather. And he grew up in that family. So,
so you are the maternal.
That's my grandfather.
Reverend
Putin.
Yes.
And some people came here some years ago or so. They came with a play, the Damu Bini. I acted the inspector of police. So,
there are, you are what we call plenipotentia. In fact, you know, the funny thing was that maybe because it's what you are looking for that you will see at times. You know, we've never associated you with the theater arts
and culture.
So it never, even if I'm watching Rere Runa, as you said, if they show that Rere Runa, now that you mentioned that, we'll now be looking for where is
it? Pastor Mulola initially was the
lead
main character. That was Lamugu.
Lamugu, yes.
But eventually, Olawo Tinu said I should take over. Because as he said, he saw me as a natural actor. So I took over from Pato Milola as Lamugu. Because I'm not to blame.
So, Olawo was a play by Olawo Tinu.
Yes. And how did we get that? We were training, rehearsing, when we started building that play. And there was somebody who was you know, you remember it? Rehearsing is about the labor
injustice,
and the government.
Exactly, exactly, yes.
It's so, like, somebody was representing Igbo worker. He was an FMR. And when Lawo lost his brain, his senses, and he was, you know, talking in, you know, madness mode. So that worker said, Rere Nati, that is, it's a pity this has happened. The worst has happened. Rere Nati, the original title was not Rere. Actually, the play was written by one of us who attended the playwright workshop with Olawo Tinu. Chief Oladejo Okedeji. He was the writer of
Ajaluleru.
That's right. He was the writer of that play from our writer's workshop.
Chief Oladejo Okedeji was the writer.
He was the writer. And the title was not read at all. But while we were rehearsing, the labor man shouted when Olawo became mad. Rere Nati Run. And Olawo said, hey, stop. What did you say it again? Rere Nati Run. Then he changed the title to Rere Run.
Wonderful. So those people, they are always sensitive. You understand? You know, he connected immediately to
the
that.
The best producer Nigeria has produced was Olawo Tinu.
In terms of stage plays.
In terms of
plays.
Yes. He was the best producer. Although he had one peculiarity. Olawo Tinu will not produce a comedy. You want something tragic. If you write a sweet story for him, he will find a way of changing it
to tragedy. What?
Because he will want you watching his play to get lost on your seat.
Leave that stage sober.
That's right.
Very
sober. Look at the girls are not okay. When a child gave birth to him, a mother gave back to a baby for his son. Through circumstances. Eventually, the son became an over. And when he discovered what happened, he committed suicide. So, one has gone through some, as I was saying, each deity in Yoruba land has its own living. Obatala you talked about, Babarubu, Obatala, Upunadagija, Ikupanapuri, Arumakabu, Amunene Kwafaine, Sonic and the Bernie, Babarubu will be there, will be there, Babarubu will be there. You see, that's a slow term. Babarubu, Babarubu, and is the chief of all deities. In fact, he's regarded as the next to Olodumare. And that is why when you see a hunchback or an albino, the Yorubas, you call him Eniolisha. Because they believe it was the wish of Obatala to create him like that. The Yorubas believe that Obatala will mold a human being after shaping it the way he wanted, will now present it to the Almighty for the breath of life. And that is why you must not make fun of all these people. The hornback, and albino. No, people with deformities. But they call them any Odisha.
So in that event in 1972, was there any accolade? How did your troupe perform?
We performed very well. Very well. Interestingly, we performed in, I think, about three cities in Germany. We performed in Munich, I think in Berlin. We performed in about, I think, three, and our performances were recorded. That was in 72. Then later that year, we were in Senegal.
The same
for play. No, a command performance for late Sarah Sengo.
Their president.
It was a command performance.
When you say command performance, what?
It means it is on special request. Special honor for somebody.
Address to Rio Lopo Theater.
Yes. We, you know, Sada Sengo was a poet.
Yes. In fact, one of the foremost African poets.
It was one of his poems that we went to render. in Germany.
In his honor.
Yes, in his honor. Dagis. Dagis. Poems written by South Africans, African journalists. Had a compilation of them.
And you were there, you know, to provide some of the talking
background. Yes. Musical background. Musical background. And for each poem, we had different tempo. Yoruba.
It's just like when you score a movie. You know, those people that provide the background.
Wonderful. It was very interesting.
So, at what point did you now move into it? Because you know you were teaching at staff school.
There were various things before then. I told you, I didn't start schooling until I was 10.
Exactly.
Because I was going to the farm, going drumming with my father's and my uncle, but my father was not a drummer. It was his brother, my uncle, who went out to Lambeth. But the whole family eventually joined him. And so I left the primary school in 1954. After the primary school, I said I was to go to government college. To the why I wasn't admitted. The hope then was that if I was admitted, I might be given a scholarship. Because I said it was a humble family. And that was one of the reasons why it was late before I started schooling. The money
required
to finance my education was part of it. In 1955, I was employed as a PUP teacher. Teachers with primary school certificates are known as PUP teachers. Because they are learners. So, I did that for 1 year before I gained admission to into a grade 3 teacher training college at Elisha, St. Peter's Teacher Training College in Elisha, who are the pioneer students. That was 56, 57. That was where I did my teacher's grade 3 course. After that, I came back to Moraike because I was sponsored by my church, by the Anglican Mission Baptist. So I had to come back to them. And then I started teaching at St. Stephen's B in Moraike. That was 1958.
And you still remember any of your pupils then? Who are still alive?
Well, still many of them. There was one young man who retired from News Agency of Nigeria, the Jola Toye.
Jola Toye
was one of them. Several of them. That was a long time. So, after teaching for 2 years, as it was required then, if you did your teacher's grade 3, you must teach for 2 years before you can go for grade 2. So after teaching for 2 years,
get the experience.
I went for the teacher's grade 2 course. I was admitted in two colleges, St. Peter's Catholic Teacher Training College at Akure, then St. Luke's College in Ibadan here. I wanted to go to Akure. But then the Anglican Mission got a wind of it. I thought I was trying to abandon the Anglican for Catholic. So they blocked me.
They were jealous.
They blocked me.
Moshe, we know they were blocking you. I'll groom you, don't get the honor statue.
So I attended St. Luke's College here in Ibadan. 1960-61. In 1960, we had a group of American undergraduates and graduates who came to Nigeria on Operation Crossroads Africa. They were going from place to place on community development projects. And they were going to be around for 2 months. They wanted students of the University of Ibadan to join them. But there was a crisis. So they couldn't get the students from the university. So they approached the teacher training colleges and my then principal, Agdikin S.A. Banjo, the soldier's name, the father of the Banjos. Came to the assembly.
When you say the band, the Banjos of the VC,
of
the vice chancellor.
Yes, their father. And Dr. Banjo of Blessed. Agdikin Banjo, Agdikin S.A. Banjo. So he announced to the students that there was a project that anybody who wanted to volunteer to join them. But then he gave a caution. He said, if you go, you are going to, you'll be away for 2 months. This you abandon your studies at the teacher's training college and go away for 2 months. So as soon as he left the assembly, myself and one friend of mine went to him in the office. And we said we wanted to. He said, he took our records right from entrance examination up to that level to see how we were performing. And when he saw that the two of us were probably the foremost in the class, he said, okay, you can go. That was how we went for 2 months. The project ended the day schools were supposed to vacate for the second term. Banjo postponed the terminal examination because of us, because of the two of us. He did it for a lot of reasons. Wanted to see how we would perform. Then he didn't want to be held responsible for whatever. So the second terminal examination started the first day of the third term. And the two of us came tops. So, let's start being away
from. Every holiday, I can't win. Eti mo tun jele ti sare lo kuru wa lo je me ko ba mo tun ko bi o ya
ti but that's another irony about me.
Okay, sir.
That's another irony about me.
Okay, sir.
When we were in the primary school,
yeah,
the curriculum was so heavy.
Mm.
The geography history we did in primary school are what they are now doing to obtain degrees.
Mm.
Economic geography, world history, and so on and so forth. Primary school. So you will write and write and write and write, but I was not used to writing notes. Because if I wrote the notes after school, as soon as I got home, my mother would say, hey,
should be the problem with Papa Ofe. Right from young age, Baba Oko Kodile, or you are very low. Because the, you know, the boy makes the man. Understand?
Because as soon as I left school, I got home, my mother would say, hey, your brothers are at so so place, drop.
Man, exactly, go and join them.
We may not come back until very early the following morning.
Wow. So, you talk about the boarding class?
When it will be. Yeah, that was
my. That's it. Class, so, and there is an engine in that brain that expands it beyond what other people are taking notes.
As if you know what is
happening. No, sir. I also met a lot of people who are like that. Look, there was a particular guy, sir. So permit me to digress. That guy, because of one reason or the other, he wasn't attending classes.
Okay.
Do you know what he would say? Just tell you, please bring the note. Can you read it to me? Just run through your notes for me. As if he's the lecturer that, and the guy would listen like this.
Magnet.
He would just listen like this. And he was the best graduating student in his generation at the Faculty of Technology in Ife.
In those days,
even
as a teacher in training, if a teacher handled a topic, and gave us 5 points on that topic. If in the examination he asked that question on that topic, I would struggle to give him 6-7 points instead of his
five.
And you cannot throw away anything.
You
know, because information you hear, you read, you see,
stays
supposed to be a guideline. You can't get everything complete.
But you know,
you must be able to turn it round and round and round.
You know, some people are actually inspired in that, they are gifted in that area. You receive that information and it opens up in your brain beyond having to go to the library.
I want to now. Modesty will not allow me to say it.
Baba say it for record purposes. Let them hear.
When I gained the appointment as a coach of the national team in 1983, some ex-internationals came up, we ganged up and protested that I had no business being appointed as the coach of the national team because I never played in the national team. Yes, I didn't play in the national team. One, there's a difference between playing and coaching. So don't get yourself confused. Where did Mourinho play football?
The best manager in the world, according to me.
What of Arigosaki?
AC Milan.
Italian coach, USA 94.
Okay. Even Arsene Wenger, how much football did he play? And these are leading coaches in the world. So there was this protest then, 1983. What I'm saying is, I attended some coaching courses. But I would not write a note, not to talk of copying anything from there. Give me an idea and let me build on it. And that was why. And you
and
were
that,
saying
that was
something.
Your strength. No, what I'm trying to say is that look, a man must know himself.
Yeah. You see, you are talking about Nigerians who are not somebody learned a book. about 2 weeks ago, History of Nigerian Football. And at the end, some people were talking to me, and I told them that the history, do pioneers have any place in history? I'm asking. Pioneers? Yes.
Have a place in history.
Do they have a place in history?
They do.
In fact, history is based on them. Ooh. On pioneers.
Yes.
It's what they produce that you are writing.
I understand.
And this man wrote History of Nigerian Football. I was the first Nigerian to handle the national team. I was the first Nigerian to take Nigeria to African Cup of Nations. I was the first Nigerian to take Nigeria to the World Cup. I was the first Nigerian to be on FIFA Technical Committee, CAF Technical Committee. And yet my name did not appear once in that book.
He said he's limited to colonial era. You were not in the colonial era. You were talking of 72, 73. 83 is post-colonial. He has challenged us to rise after the colonial.
See what he said, because you are saying, we are asking about...
So it's a marketing error, sir. It's a marketing error. They changed the title. Because it's either you, and that's why I said that, as far as I'm concerned, even if you say history of Nigerian football, cap it and say the first 40 years or the first 50 years, so that we know the remit of the period you are talking about. But you can't come and... for me, it was so strange. Look, you can't do it in... And when we looked at the few number of pages, they got up to 60.
Yes.
Devoted to the core.
Yeah, to the core.
The issue of the title.
Yeah.
That can be. I knew you were trying to salvage, because I was getting a bit
violent. I was trying to save him.
Yes.
If I had come out with all this,
you have defeated the...
I mean, the book is rubbish. And as they do in... academic societies, I will have turned the book into pieces in the process there. It was rubbish. And that's exactly what it is. Rubbish.
Because it doesn't make... I mean, you can imagine, you tell... Because when you told me about Mr. Kunle Sholaja,
yes.
We met him.
Yes.
We have taken some footage down of him. And in fact, he gave us 2 books. You understand? The one that you mentioned,
yes.
Super Eagles... From 1949 to that's whatever.
Right. That's right.
Then another one, Goals of Super Eagles or something. Right. You know? Wonderful.
So, and you are talking about this team.
Yes. So, how did you get into coaching?
Very good. It's another irony in my life. In my primary school days,
yes.
I would play inter-class matches at break time. Which they use in selecting the school team. And I was always selected. But the school team would train after school hours when I would be a weight drummer. So I never played in the primary school team.
Oh my God.
I never played in the primary school team. But when I went for my teacher's grade 3, we were pioneer students. We were only 29 in the class. We had to raise a team. That was where I actually picked up. I was playing, as I said, I was playing inter-class in primary school.
Yeah.
But school team, no.
No. So when you now go to grade?
When I went for my teacher's grade 3, we were few in number and we had to raise a school team. Not only in football.
Across all sports.
And that is why. The day I attended the interview with the sports council, to join the sports council in 1974. I attended 2 interviews. Athletics coach, football coach. And I came top in the 2. Before.
So they are now had to decide which one.
Where do you go? It was late Isaac Akinyi who said I should go into football. That was one of the people who built Nigerian sports.
Isaac Akinyi.
But again, he was like me.
Mm.
He was victimized until he died.
Mm.
because he would not join the bandwagon of fraudsters.
Hmm.
It's a big problem in this country.
Hmm.
If you don't join them, then trouble.
Yeah, trouble. You are in trouble.
Today, if you go to the NFA people, say, why are you not taking Chief Onukwere along? That man is difficult. They will tell you.
Hmm.
And what is my difficulty? I'm not going there.
Let's be
open.
What is this that
the chop? The chop will come if you do it right. But the first thing that we want to do, when Lamadeshina, the soul rest in peace, it took him 5 months to get me convinced to come back to Shooting Stars, to revive the Shooting Stars. Shooting Stars was in relegation for about 3 years. It took him 5 months. I told him I had been with Shooting Stars 6 times. I didn't want to come the 7th time. So at one of these meetings, we were 4. The governor, the deputy governor, and the SLG, myself. When I continued resisting, he said, Chief, I cannot understand why people say you are difficult. And I laughed. I said, yes, let me tell you why I'm difficult. You have now, you are getting me convinced to come and do a job. Some people are already looking at what will be their share from what you give me for the job. What will happen to the job? When we share the money. Then I drew an analogy. I said, this is the deputy governor, this is the SIG and myself. The three of us are farmers. It was time to plant yam. They didn't have seed yams. I gave them 1,000 each. The deputy governor said he had their visitors, he was hungry, put the thing on fire and ate yam. The SSG went and planted his own. Who is going to benefit? At the end of it, he said the man who planted his own. That's my idea. The money you want to use to develop is what people want to share in Nigeria. And it eventually happened. When I eventually agreed, because the man was begging, agreed and I committed him. You allow me to do it the way you should go and said, you are free. Please don't report anything to me. Give me your budget. I gave him a budget of 80 million for the year. Top civil servants convinced him to give me half first. That was 2002. Up till today, the remaining half.
Even in his grave.
You see? And when I got in, I said, okay, since you have given me a free hand, please just sit in your office and watch what I do. And I called the so-called supporters. Do you know that in Nigeria, you don't have one football club in Nigeria? I said it the other. Not one. Because FIFA statute says the governing board of any football body must be democratically elected. When did the Rangers conduct their election?
Sharks, Sunshine Stars.
Bende.
Dolphin.
Shooting.
So
we don't have one club. And I said, okay, you supporters come. What's your name? They say, we are supporters. They say, you are cheating yourself. You are not supporters. You are the club. Let every one of you give me 1,000 naira and I will give you club membership card. Not supporter card. Club, you are already a member of the club. As at that time, I should be able to get 1 million people who call themselves Shooting Stars supporters. 1 million times 1,000.
You said so.
I got 1 billion. What couldn't I do? Compare 1 billion with 40 million they gave me.
Exactly.
Which I used to gain promotion. So, these are the issues.
So, now,
the Shooting Stars would have been the biggest in Africa today. In terms of affluence, everything. Because that 1 billion naira, what do I want to do? In the first instance, with 1 billion naira, I can bring back home all those Nigerian stars who are playing abroad.
Exactly.
What are you there? What are you looking for? Money. Okay, the money is there now. Let's go. Then I will go into industries, supermarket, and all the rest of it.
So,
and the credibility is there.
Very important.
So all I would have done, when you get my membership card in your area, you will form Shooting Stars Club, so area. You'll be holding your meetings. Let's restrict ourselves to Ibadan here. Then representatives from various areas will come together to select
the overall. So when late Isaac Akioye now influence your choice of becoming a football manager, what happened next?
So I joined the sports council in 1974.
Okay.
As I said. We had an expatriate boss there, Alan Hawks. He was conducting seminars for us. And we were sent to different corners of the Western region there, principally for development. What is the job of the sports council? To develop.
Yes.
It's not their business to run competitions. It is the respective association, sports association, that is organizing. But the sports council has to develop. They employed several of us. Somebody in Eruwa, somebody in Shaki, somebody in Malaysia. By the time I retired in 1988, we were 14 football coaches. Western State.
West.
14.
But is that 14? Was that 14 as a number adequate? Even at that.
At that time, it was not adequate.
But at least we had.
Tell me, how many coaches do they have on the sports council today? Probably two or three football coaches. So, when any team got into a national competition then, we will be assigned to go and assist them, not as a direct coach, to build them up. And that was how in 1976, I was sent to Germany for the German A license course.
I did Germany. 1972, Baba Law, Cultural True, Germany.
74.
74. 76. Germany, no, Jumbo.
I did an attachment with the Hertha BSC of Berlin.
Hertha Berlin.
In February. I attended the German A license course in March. In April, I did an attachment with MSV Duisburg. Before I came back to Nigeria. As soon as I came back, I was posted in Oyo to develop football. It was from there I was recalled when Water Corporation and Shooting Stars qualified for the National League finals. The National League was not like this then. They would go into zones. The best team
will now emerge from the zones and now be part of the
playoff.
So
Water qualified from their zone, Shooting Stars qualified from their zone, and then Bender Insurance and ACB.
Africa Continental.
And the playoff was to be in Lagos. So I was assigned. My boss, Alan Hoff, was handling Shooting Stars. So I was assigned to Water Water Corporation. You know the irony of it? The first day I was introduced to water officials, they were saying it behind me. They didn't know I said, you know, they didn't say that they don't like us. Look at the coach. Who is this coach? Where did he get this coach?
Kilo Tishé. Kilo Mo. Give the credential. I saw. Oh my God.
He never played in any big club. On the top of the national team. They don't want us to qualify. They didn't know I had what they were saying.
So the following morning.
To feel what? Yeah,
no.
Results
will speak.
That's not my life. Results will speak.
That's not my life. So the following morning, the boys came for training.
I don't know, like that is the guy. We can get there. You know where to go.
I say, gentlemen.
Stamina building, yeah. Let's test your stamina. No,
I didn't even start that way.
For permission,
I was asking them. I said, look, what are your problems in this club? And they said the sports council don't like us. The general public don't like us. You see, a reverberation of what I had yesterday from the official. That I was assigned to them because they didn't like them, because the authorities didn't like them. I said, okay, boys, what have you achieved for these people to admire, to appreciate? What do you want them to like you for?
Never tip out as you
want. Are we ready to win them back? They said, okay, let's go, boys. When we got to Lagos for the competition, you know, Chipley Kansalamin is so recent. Was a very strong voice in the Nigerian football with diabetes. And he was the owner of shooting. When we got to Lagos, they did their fixture, and the opening match was Shooting Stars Water. So water officials came to visit.
Alaox, you know what? These 3 years, I've been shooting stars. Only Pete, no one, no one, water, at the resort.
And for opening match, the competition, they said they wanted us out quickly. They didn't talk to me, yes. Whatever fears you have, so I talked to my players, you know, in football, football coaching, there is a topic, football fitness.
A topic in the fitness.
Football fitness.
Mm.
A lot of coaches in Nigeria, even all over the world, misunderstand that terminology.
Football fitness.
When you talk of, you see a coach in the morning, what do you have to do? Say fitness training. It's rubbish. And what he means by fitness training is physical, you know, football fitness is more than that. And one of them is what I was talking about. Psychological fitness. Psychological fitness. Are you properly attuned?
Mentally.
When you are talking about mentally again, you are going to another area of football fitness. Intellectual fitness. How much of football do you know? Can you read football?
Even when playing.
If you cannot read football, how do you react?
Which is what is warning most of my United players.
You see the problem in Nigerian football?
They can't read.
So we started, it's not about running around chasing the ball.
Read the game. Spot the gaps.
And that is why when I came back from the World Cup, I went to Alaba Market to buy some red papers. As soon as I alighted, some young boys, about 50 or more of them, Dada ran me. Coach. And at a point, they all did this. Mimicking me.
Okay.
That I would just sit down. 2002. That I would just sit down and bench. I would not stand up doing what? I had trained the boys on what to do. When I sit on that bench, I become a spectator. An analyst. So, but if you have not prepared your players intellectually to understand what football is,
they will think because you are not flapping around on the sideline.
Do you know what? You are confusing your players.
Exactly.
And you are distracting their attention. I'm not saying I don't usually. When the need arises,
not just to be there,
I look for a break. If the break is not coming, I just signal to my players. One of them will look at me. You know what I mean? That is one of you should fall down. The next body comes back. I will seek that opportunity to now go in and say, you tell this man, tell him to do this, tell him to do this. And even without doing that, if I give my signal, they look at me, and I do that, you know I'm asking them to attack from the right. Attack from the right. Attack from the middle. Fall back.
So it's a sign language, you should understand what the coach is saying.
Exactly. Okay. Body language. So, we played that match, and we beat Shooting Stars 2-1.
Wow.
It was a good match. Then the whole crowd were shouting, water. Don't play them in Ibadan again, no. Bring them to Lagos here. So they have been cheating you in Ibadan. And from there, I was getting materials for water before Shooting Stars could get here. They like you now, they don't like you. Action speaks louder than voice. Eventually came second.
A statement was made.
A statement was made. We came second because of the authorities. Shooting Stars was first, Water second. And Shooting Stars won the African Cup in 1976. They had to defend that cup. Now they came first now. The first team will go for Champions Cup. The Shooting Stars now ganged up and they said they were not going to defend the Winners' Cup, but they were going for the Champions Cup. The matter was eventually resolved by CAF, which insisted that they must defend the cup they won. Then Water, who came second, to go for the champion. That was how it went in 1977. Champion Cup. We were the first team to beat Hafia of Guinea in Nigeria. They came to Nigeria here and beat
Nigeria. My dad was always telling me about that game. Afia. Because those guys were smoking hot in that era.
They were leading us, I think, 2-0. People were already leaving the stadium. Well, I'm like, okay, let's go. And we won 4-2, I think. But when we went for the second leg in Conakry, Amorfa, everything was against us. Chief Lekan Salami decided to be the leader of delegation, an arch enemy of the team. Right from the pre-match meeting, he started blasting the referee, the match commissioner, everything.
He enraged all of them. Those guys just decided that he was a setup.
It was. And Hafia, who eventually went, they beat us. I can't remember. They qualified for the semi-final. They didn't play that semi-final because the team they were to play against was disqualified.
They disqualified.
So that was the year Nigeria would have won the Champion Cup for the first time at Water Corporation. But we were skimmed out.
By ourselves.
I've been going through that
because of local politics. Local sporting politics.
The same thing, my African Cup of Nations in 1984. The final against Cameroon was bought by Nigerians, strong Nigerians who believed that the honor shouldn't go to Mudanike. By the time we left Nigeria, nobody gave us a chance of even moving to the second round. And we eventually got to the final. The match was bought and sold. I don't know how we can get all this in together. In 1983, when I was appointed the first coach to Hamburg, the advertisement was placed. I brought the advertisement to my colleagues in Ibadan. We have been looking for this for a long time. We have been agitating that a Nigerian should be appointed to handle the national team. This is the opportunity, this is the advertisement. Any one of you who is interested, please.
Yes, apply.
I was the chairman in Western State here then. Then they asked me, they said, Chief, have you applied? I said, apply for what? For this job. Who am I? Who is going to do it for me? When you have people like Alabie Esen, Demezwe, the man from Rangers, you have them there. Who is my godfather? Who is going to help me? Then one of them asked, I said, look, are these people you have mentioned as good as you are? I said, of course, if they play grand one level. But is the playground ever level in Nigeria?
No, sir.
You must have a godfather. It was these people who virtually forced me to submit my application a day after closing date. I took my application to Lagos. And somehow I was invited for interview. Seven of us were invited out of over 60 who applied. How did I know I was invited? The then president of Coaches Association, Emmanuel Umenu, came from Lagos. He came to watch a match as match commissioner in Ibadan here. He got to our office at the Liberty Stadium. He was asking for me. They said I was not around. I said, please, when he comes, tell him he has an important letter in Lagos, NFA. He should go and collect it. He told me, on Thursday, I went to Lagos. Understand that I have a letter. But they said, yes, but somebody has collected it. I said, who? They mentioned the name of the player. The player was from Ibadan here. He was in the national team. When they gave them a break, collected the letter. Up to today, since
1983,
I have not set my eyes on him. Not to talk of the letter.
I don't understand. He took a letter that did not belong to him.
Yes.
And that was not addressed to him. And you have not seen him since that
up to today, I have not seen him.
You have not even heard about him. Or his whereabouts.
About 3 months ago, some newspaper published what I'm saying. That he was responsible for it. Then he challenged me, he called me, That was the first time I heard from him. He said he didn't collect any letter. I said, So I now asked the staff. Now
there must be file copy.
So they gave me the file copy. On Thursday, we are to come for interview on Monday. Make a 2-year technical program for the national team. Bring 15 copies. Your certificate, testimonial, everything, bring 15 copies on Thursday. Friday, Saturday, I was in Modaike for the funeral of an in-law.
So how do you arrange all this?
I came back on Sunday and started writing my program. The program was running to about 10 pages. I said, okay, what do we do? I went for the interview. The remaining 7 of us, I mean the remaining 6, were, you know, prominent coaches, ex-internationals. When I brought my file, while we were waiting for our turn, when they saw, it was then some of them started tearing paper to write the program. There were some of us who didn't come with a sheet of paper as wide as a sheet of paper. And I brought a load.
So, but for that reason, this is just a routine, formality.
It's already been selected. I think that would be the coach.
I was with the panel for 1 hour 20 minutes.
Don't try that.
Then at a point, the chairman said, well, coach, gentlemen, we have had him. We have learned a lot from this discussion. Mm. I knew they were in trouble. Mm. You are learning from
WWE. London Fashola at the National Assembly.
You will hear from us. Mm. Thank you, sir. I went away. About 2 weeks later, I went to Lagos to thank the then secretary, Yinka Okewu, who was a friend. We had met at several athletics, football coaching courses. I went to thank him. And when I got to his office, Beck, where is the secretary? He said, our guy is sick. Mm. The doctor said he should rest from last week. Then I was talking with another colleague I met there. Then Yinka came in. Mm. And the staff said, Oga, why? The doctor said you should rest. He said, I've come because of this man. He wanted to me. Then follow me to my office. We were about three. We followed him. Before we sat down, he said, gentlemen, meet our new national chief coach. I said, Yinka. Now then, don't talk. See me, they make jest of me. He said, I'm serious. He said, when you left the panel, every one of them dropped their biro. Wondering, who is this man? From where is this man? Then he brought out the fight to me, the scores. I was on 68% aggregate. And the next man to me, Alabi Eshe, was on 65. I was on 78.
He was on 65.
He was on 65. The next man told me, out of 7. He said, Cameron, congratulations. Then there was a media man on that panel, Yinka Craig. So rest in peace. He flashed something in his paper, Concord. An unknown man for national chief coach. Look forward to details. And when he came out with the details, an unknown man from Modakeke, blah, 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 was a member of the board of the NFA until December. 82. He was the strongest man on that board. Stronger than the chairman because he was a money man. A lawyer. When the results were announced, this man was out of the country at the time the interview was conducted. Then he rushed back. And he invited me. He said, coach, congratulations. You were lucky I was not in the country. He told me. Before then, he had gone through the sports commission, the presidency, to get the result changed. We decided this is an experiment. This is the first time we want to use it in Nigeria. I'm sure we must select whoever is the best. Exactly. If that best fails, then we know Nigerians cannot do the job. That was the argument. He said, well, but before I left, I told them who to employ. It was when I heard your name that I had to dash back. She was a strong man. But don't worry, I will help you. I will support you. Thank you, sir. The support he gave me was that throughout 83, I was not given one ball for the national team. I went about begging for balls. I came to Ibadan here, collected balls from the sports council. 35 balls. Some people gave me money to buy for the national team. When Abiola
MKO,
may so rest in peace. When he noticed what was happening, then he asked somebody to bring me to him. I never met him in my life. Just reading about him. He saw me on his close circuit. We were on the queue. as if going into a cinema house. Okay.
At Toyin Street, in his house, or where?
Jibu.
Okay, oh, okay, Jibu.
IIT, what is the name of his company? Okay.
IIT.
IIT.
It can't be IIT.
Not IIT,
mm-hmm.
IT.
ITT.
ITT. ITT. ITT.
So, he said, yeah, I should come, I should come. I leave the queue. He went to me. Said, we talked for about 1 hour. Mm. He said, Egbon, gbogbo ti won fi oju ni ri gbogbo e ni mo gbo gbogbo e ni mo ri won fe le yin lo ni ibi ti e ti wa e ki sagun nbe e ma lo anything you need from today come and get from me
eh
o se bi ti ibi ti mo so pe yo mo ni. Now having somebody like Abiola.
Ah, the pillar. Africa pillar.
Before God and man, up to today, I never went to him to ask for a cover. But the way he talked to me, it was like not coming, it emboldened my spirit.
Ewa ranti pe ki se bale oni lu jagun ni o of the jagun community of boda keke.
So mo se bele ni that was how I got into the national team as a coach. I'm a Catholic mission. Wan kala go wa so. Way of life. How to please God. To acquire. In a sort of duty.
You are difficult. I can now see why they say you are difficult.
Yes, sir.
March
6th, yeah. March 27th. She bomb away from anything bombing. A fair more so the phone until you call it a name. Bishop, you don't know. Not to talk of church.
But only if I mean, no why, no name, or
Lord. That is in Roman, that chapter 12.
And you know, yes, you cook over. Come, I live on Lord.
And you know, you say, Lenny?
And you know, only quit Tabachi Bay. And you
know, you don't quit, you know, you pay. Wa kere nti anse
be ni baba o
gbo so won lo ko fun
baba awon ota ni won oni ni gba to mi
eti mo ka ita lo so
Jesus ni gbo ota la mo ara bi yen
eh
oni gba to mi iyan sun ota e wa
gbo wa ni suru o ko let me read up sure fun awon ti o nfi yin re si gbadura fun awon ti o ke gan yin abutale pe lota
ben a n gbadura fun lati ku eyin na le won lori baba o taburu
eni ti o ba si lu o ni ereke kan yi ekeji pada
baba oko lo ma mu abi ke yo fese fe benisa ke yo fese fe ni baba. Ah, I ti koja gugu ile so e.
Baba be Jesus.
Iwa bi Olorun ati pere die die ni.
Baba be Jesus.
Baba iwa bi Olorun ati pere die die. O lere pupo. Baba o lere pupo to ba lo ko e kekeji. Baba e ma ko to ba ko jale le o.
Ati en ti o ba gbada re. Ma se da duro lati gba ewu awotele re pelu.
Baba eyin ni je o gbagbada o awon yen fe bu e si o ni e won o gbodo de be mo ti e godo sumo yan debi to ma gbagbada
apa gbe gbogbo teachers ni
baba ti mo so di pe
Jesus so bi kan
yes sir
o ni ore mi ni eyin je bi eyin bi a se ohun ti mo pa lase fun yin baba
e mo to so e mo
being a friend of Jesus is conditional
yes sir cherry nkan kokan ti mo fe o ni o ni oluwa sam lo wa o
yes
bi iwo ba nsa mi ese do ma duro ṣugbọn idariji n be lodo re ka le ma beru be se ri nkan ti mo fe ke ṣakiyesi sa o ni wipe because your order of meekness in this particular place mo ti evaluate e in the context of ya bawo la se pe ogun ajeja ta ba se bayi awon eyan mo amọ mo wa wa te mole ṣugbọn wa wa te mole baba igba elomi ade te mole pe ko
mo lese yen lo awon eniyan te n so yi
be ni la
won lagbara jọ lọ lọ
mo o lagbara jọ lọhun lọ na bo ta mo pe dajọ ọlọrun
ntorun modest
yes sir
ntorun modest
yes sir
ntorun modest
yes sir
ọjọ kan wa ni sitting room
yes sir
ata ya wo awon ma ya mi gbogbo gbogbo
be
bo ya an sawa data an se ri be ya mi ba gbo e ah ah o mo ki lo gbe o ka lo kuwa gbo mo ki lo gbe o le me lo wo ki mo wa se ni ntẹni kan ba ti so pe mo le dabu pa ata kan gbo laye ni won ki won ala bo nko ni bi to n joko si pe pe kon ayo ni so se agbara re ni
pe ke ni kan ba so laye
pe mo le dabu pa ata kan gbo laye ko lo won so ko lo ni
kini ori ngba ni tamo laro ti ni ri to ri differently kini mama ri nigba yen to yato si nkan ti awon olaro ti ni because on to olaro ti ni ri o po ju nkan to ngo le so lo
be ni
awon mommy o de ri yen
be ni coaching ti mo di kini bi mo so background fun
be ni ogo nla ni
ta lo se
bawo mommy o se rogo nla ta nso yi
yo se ri bele na ara ni sugbon o lo igbagbo gbogbo nbi ti o ba gba mo ti o ma ile yin
Baba, you feel very strong,
sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Ndi mo nka awon itan e mo bere.
Eh, awa ti ba so ye lo. So mo ko fe bere pe ko. In the course of your career as a football coach, as a theater, cultural,
eti ma as a politician,
as a politician, eti ma lawon orisirisi materials. Your library, your, I mean things that are very important to you. Can you plan me for our materials? What are
well,
your plans?
For now, yes, my plan is to leave all these things for the children. Because persecution time, sorry, it has not ended in my life. I told you 5 years ago, 6 years ago, some people came here, I told you. One of them called biography. Tí n bá lo òkè náà sì ń gé lọ mú draft ẹ wá ọkọ̀ ó tó báyìí 6 years ago tó ìdò ní kò jáde àwọn kan ní ẹwà ń jẹ.
So ṣe máa fi instruction sílẹ̀ fáwọn
bí wọ́n ṣe. Well, I'm already, you know, fortunately I have a close kind of family. My children are always with me. Any issue, I let them. Think I come back to let me to fish a little. Learn your lessons. They are bad looking, eh? You see my library, everything. In my study. Football, thanks, sorry. But when I finish, look, when I finish, say coaching course, don't it? It was my paper. It is still my paper. I have a presentation with about 120 slides. Slide the main bed mode she will make talonia. I was talking to you about football fitness. There was often an average Nigerian coach, even international coach.
Football it's something there it is so because commissioner will mention how can you mention pe elo Brazil ni 81 e soro nipa e jo so ko so so pe o mo pe in the first
ko bodo ma mo baba e ni chairman sports council gba ni hmm e ko so pe omo mi lo
be ni
baba e ni chairman sports council
I need
it but ani awon ti o lo tan kan pe o baba e lo pe emi ni ki lead awon to lo ameta la lo hmm but a wa lohun won yan enikan bi coordinator wa hmm he was a old influential coach Walter Miraglia nigba ta debe Friday la won Brazilian coaches association man se meeting to be there and she change it Monday pe matches si weekend
ka analyze
Brazil wa play a match kan international match go the Monday and then we analyze the match only some wa be say na mo fun wa o to wa analyze and to coach won gba yen mo wa break it down to ba wa si Africa wa coach afia eventually he did he went to Saudi Arabia he went to South Africa he failed mo wa analyze the match ti won gba boy to lo ni left full back junior ni won pe he was playing for Flamengo
the junior of the national team to play for national team Brazil
national team.
The black man
that's
with
right.
the big hair
that's right he was playing for Flamengo mo de sise pelu Flamengo for about 2 months mo so witness
junior
fun coach won o de ti tori timi o lo employ a left winger to ma lock back kini problem junior to ba ti gba ball ba o lo ni
then
contract back ko ni defensive mindset
and he was playing at left full back
hmm
ba ti gba ball ba e ri ni outside right
that's the discipline now
he played it to walk up
no position
alongside Socrates
positional discipline oh iwo to wa level back to wa long back ni outside right
position that is my type of football
okay man
team tin ba kojo to ba de pe you are a player position wo lo ngba left football and what nothing more ma lo ni wo in modern football you must be able to play
modern
anywhere there is work to be done gone were the days of departmentalizing
okay, football.
A football team. Defenders, attackers, midfield. Nti mo so yo asoni FIFA technical committee. The then technical director of UEFA, Rochbaugh. No big big in there. Okay, in football, you have 3 phases: attacking, defending, and the intermediary or whatever to confusion to the game. In football, you are either attacking
or you are defending.
Or defending. Push break. Because Tiamba from Philip Penny can foul. She break in it. Match I do be. But isn't a team in possession?
Of course, because one team is going to kick that ball.
And he got free kick yen kilo fa se
o ti take possession
he wants to initiate an attack
really
kill our opponent ma ma se they must be thinking on how to defend that attack
and recover the ball
is that a break
no not a break
and when you create that impression in your players we want the time you are breaking your team every time back ball le won fa gba free kick won players won mo le ra won ka kick
bo se won
se break ni yen
good
Which cost us US 94 second goal against Argentina?
Any team, I want team won to fe gba free kick. Won wa bi team ti ma duro gba ball.
Be ni bo se wa ni ba.
Awon opponent wa bi won se disturb won ki won mo re ball gba. Se break ti wa.
I really appreciate your time, sir.
So, on mo fin so nigbati junior He's playing my type of football. It is left to the coach. Even Timo ni Flamengo coach ise o lo gba left winger. Come on, Petit Junior ba ti lo yan o ti lock. Left winger ni ti lock. Titi ti na to ma fi recover. That is football. People watch. Match yan you play 10 minutes, ta won supporters bere si paru. Oni gbe le yan ti ma ko lo ba wo lo party mo yi. Ségun to gbe si ségun tan ba pade ni club la na to ti mo ti o. Ti sare kiri bi wele. So ni se nji re ni.
Na ba ga ni le lekuru.
Elekuru abi na abi ko na wuri. Awon baba yen when I came back to shooting in 2002. I approved life salary for him. Life salary. Now, kini mo so pe
ito na kale la game sir.
I won match in 4-1.
I remember sir.
No four goals. Segun score kan by the carelessness of the opponent. Ngba ta pari match, awon viewers wa believe it on television pe. Segun, why did you play like that? But only I did what the coach asked me to do and we won. What was the strategy? Bo mo pa yen won ti mura e wa. Ti mo ba lo okan won ba le.
Ben.
But mo wa lo mo si fun ni different assignment.
Which is what you did in Japan, Korea 2002 with Kanu Wankuo.
That's right.
Beko masaka ki lori field.
To ba lo right.
Ma tele.
Won bi meta o tele.
Ma open space.
To ba lo left. By the time te yen meji tele nikan, mo ti ni free man kan.
Yes sir.
Awon yen knock and goals.
That is.
So these are the issues. To our football. Which up to today, I want to put down one coach again on Matumare. Coaches made in Nigeria. Bill Bunya Bawa Tan Son. So, something about so you. Well, I become a modest. Never I call. There's so. I believe in one thing. We are in primary school. I call a poem. Work while you work and play while you play. To be useful and happy, this is the way. All that you do, do with your might. Things done by half are never done right. You are involved in a situation, it must be 100%, your concentration and everything. Because when you hold something back, you are not doing it right. Walk while you walk and play while you play. To be useful and happy, this is the way. All that you do, do with your might. Things done by half are never done right. Tell them about your world. Make sure you are looking for the other. Tell them about your but wahala tani. Especially in your donation, own shame can you believe in what you are doing? But because of what people will say and what they will do, you pull back. Are you doing it right?
No, sir.
Then how do you succeed? If you don't believe in what you are doing, then leave it and do something else. But if you believe in it, then do it right.
Stay the course.